In this video, let's take a closer look at the conservation of matter. The law of the conservation of matter, which is also sometimes called the conservation of mass, says that matter cannot be created or destroyed in a chemical reaction. The scientist who discovered this principle was Antoine Lavoisier. In 1772, Lavoisier combusted phosphorus in partially enclosed systems. He noticed that the mass of the phosphorus was greater after heating. The science of the time did not accurately explain the increase. Eventually, Lavoisier was able to show that the oxygen involved in the combustion was adding the mass. That led him to realize that, although matter can change its state, the total mass is the same at the end of a reaction as it is at the beginning of the reaction. In a chemical reaction, all that actually happens is that atoms are rearranged. Take a look at this example. On the reactant side, there are four hydrogens, and there are also two oxygen atoms present in one oxygen molecule. As the reaction takes place, the atoms are rearranging. When the reaction stops, there are two water molecules, but the number of atoms remains the same. Two oxygen atoms and four hydrogen atoms on the product side. Here's a conservation of matter problem. If 55 grams of sodium reacts with chlorine to form 135 grams of sodium chloride, how many grams of chlorine reacted? In this reaction, sodium and chlorine are the reactants. They are combining to form the product, which is sodium chloride. Since the law of conservation of matter states that the total mass of the products must be the same as the mass of the reactants, the mass of sodium and chlorine has to equal 135. So 55 plus the mass of chlorine will equal 135. Rearrange that by subtracting 55 from 135, and you find that the mass of chlorine is 80 grams in this reaction, and the total mass of the reactants is equal to the total mass of the products. Here's another conservation of matter problem. If 32 grams of sulfur reacts with exactly 56 grams of iron, how much iron sulfide compound will be formed? In this reaction, the iron and the sulfur are the reactants. They're going to combine to form the iron sulfide compound, which is the product. 32 plus 56 should add up to be the mass of the iron sulfide, which is the product. When you add those two numbers together, the 32 grams from sulfur plus the 56 grams from iron, you find that the total mass of the iron sulfide compound has to be 88 grams. Here's one for you to try. In the reaction between aluminum metal and oxygen gas, 267 grams of aluminum oxide are formed when 141 grams of aluminum reacts. How many grams of oxygen were needed? When you're ready, press pause, and then press play to check your calculation when you think you have the answer. Here's the answer to the problem. The aluminum and oxygen are the reactants, which combine to form aluminum oxide, which is the product. You take the 141, which is the mass of aluminum, and when you add that to the mass of oxygen, it should equal 267. Rearrange the equation for the mass of oxygen by subtracting 141 from 267, and you find that the mass of oxygen in the reaction was 126 grams, and the number of atoms in the reactant and the products are the same. So this calculation fits the law of the conservation of matter. That's a closer look at the law of the conservation of matter. If you'd like more Chemistry Matters, go to the homepage where the entire series is available to you.